Hello everybody and welcome on into another set review. Today I'm reviewing set number 60289 Airshow Jet Transporter with 281 pieces, recommended for ages 5 and up, and is from the LEGO City 2021 Winter line of sets. You can get this for $30. Personally, I received this as a gift, so let's get on into the minifigures. So the minifigures of the set are very simplistic. Here you have the driver Oryk be the pilot, but I'm using these in the orientation, or, you know, like the way that they were told in the instructions, I guess, if that makes sense. Here's the driver. She has a nice dual molded cap, ponytail piece, and jacket, and sunglasses, and she has no extra face as the pilot does. She falls down. No extra face on the back. But that face print that she has there is pretty cool and can be used for a multitude of reasons, I'm sure. Second pilot, and second minifigure is the pilot. He has the new helmet pieces from the City 2019 from 2020 Sky Police sets, I believe. He has a cool Airshow Jet torso with the wings and some navy blue pants. He has no alternate face. Jeez, everybody's just falling down. And here's his alternate face, just kind of a smiling face there. So, those were the minifigures that kept falling over. Now, let's get right into this build. So, the build of the set is actually really cool, and it's very underrated. So, first off, let's start off with the cab. So, you have the front with these cool, the front looks very cool. Have some warning lights, or like wide load lights, some rear view, or some mirrors, some big lights on the top, and some lights over here, a window in the back to maybe look at the load, and a crate in here that holds just some other accessories, backlights, big wheels, and the trailer hitch. And he's built on this one big base, wheel base, I don't know what to call it, but that's that. On the inside, there's nothing much. There's representation of a seat cushion, steering wheel, and a coffee mug. And there's no doors that actually open up on the set, but that's quite alright, I think, for, you know, what they were intending. But the accessories in here, my hand is just right in the way, is the hat. Is a hat for the pilot when you don't want his helmet on. Some guiding lights. Two guiding lights here. And some tools to maybe fix up the truck or the plane or whatever. Let's move on to the trailer itself. It's a pretty simple trailer. I like the back here. I like this set of lights in the back here. Has the set wheel, holders or whatever. Some lights up on the front here. Warning lights. Special transport. Someone told me this, that this set is the same color scheme as that helicopter transport from 2019, I think. So that's pretty cool. Wide load indicators. Let's turn out. So that way, you know, when you have your jet on there, wide load indicators. You get two sets of wheels up front, two sets of wheels in the back, and they didn't bother to fill this in, which I understand. I mean, it's $30, you don't want to move the price up any more than you want it to, so that's understandable. And other than that, it's pretty cool. The hitch here is just a plate with holes in it. And it just goes, slips right onto there, and it turns. But when it turns like that, obviously that wheel will hit, raise up against these fuel tanks, which I forgot to mention. Let's do the jet individually, then we will move on to the jet with the trailer and everything. So here's the jet, looks pretty cool. Let's start off with the front. On here says Captain Hiko, I think that's what his name is, in the Comets Airshow. Looks pretty nice, honestly. On the inside, there's a really cool seat build. Like, that's amazingly detailed as it comes out. There's a joystick and a new print in there, if my memory serves me correctly. So that's cool. And just four studs for your pilot to sit on. Towards the middle, we have these engine intakes, which look really cool. They're very snug to the body of the jet. And then we have two big triangular wings, along with the two Anakin Interceptor-style foil or ailerons. Navigational lights, obviously. And people have been wondering where the engines are supposed to be on this plane. I figured it out. They are right there, right underneath the wings. They look really cool. I love this. I like this design so that way the engines aren't just sticking out like a sore thumb. And it's hidden and it looks nice. Underneath there you just have landing gear. And that's about it. Yeah, that's really about it. Lots of pretty fairly big pieces in this set, but let's take a look at it all together. Here is the whole set together. It looks really cool. Obviously it moves, and you can move swivel these out. The wings are a bit longer than the wide load indicators, but I think it does the job pretty well. I mean, I'm not too nitpicky about that, but yeah. I do recommend, though, keeping the crate on the back of the truck there. Just makes it look better when it's holding the load, you know what I mean, as I drop it. So yeah, let's take a look at the instructions, the box, and the final verdict. So overall, this set is pretty good, but first off, before we get to the final verdict, let's look at the instructions. One of mine has a little bit of water damage. Some I spilled some orange juice on it a little while ago, so that one has water damage, and this one, perfectly fine, though. And one thing I don't like that they did was they made the background just kind of plain. I wish that they would have kept the background of, like, the box for the instruction manuals, just, yeah. So this one builds the truck, and the trailer. This set contains three bags in all. Obviously, here's the bully thing at the end, which is weird when it's usually bag one. You usually build that first. Here are the other sets. I'm sure if you watched my 60286 review, you know what sets I do and do not have, and if not, go take a look at that video. It's pretty cool. Obviously the win free Lego thing at the end. On this one, on the jet instructions, it has the parts info, and I think that's about it. There's no really advertisements. I guess it shows the features of the jet and the same picture from the previous manual. Let's take a look at the box art. The box is pretty cool. It shows like a grandstands kind of thing, almost like it's a Thunderbird show or something. Side of the box is pretty generic. Just has the set name in different languages. Here's kind of like a comic book storyline, I guess. Like, he took off, he's doing some stunts, and now he's landing and just doing some after show tune-ups just to make sure his plane is all good and ready to go into the next plane show. And then the truck is taking it to the next show while he maybe gets a taxi or whatever. Usually whenever I play with the set, I just keep him in the cab while the truck drives along, so probably not the safest thing, but whatever. Other side of the box just has, like, you know, warnings. The top shows like parts, and another little storyline. She took the crate while he was sitting on it, and well, he's falling off. The actual size reference, there you can see the face print a little bit better. On the bottom, nothing really too special, but yeah. So overall, the set is really good. I think you're getting a good deal for what you're getting. I mean, three builds for $30. That's quite good. And also, if you're building with a friend or sibling, it comes with two instruction manuals. So if, like, your friend builds the truck and you can build the jet, bam, you have an... Or, like, if you have siblings and you can only... Or you have children and you can only buy one set at that time, this would be a really good option to buy, so that way they can both build and play and whatever. I don't really have any qualms with the set. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know, honestly. Maybe add another little something, but I think just as it is now is really good. I don't think they could have added anything. So, overall, I'm going to give this set a B. I'm going to give the set an A. Really good set. If you find it and you're interested in it, get it. But if you're not interested in it, but you might want it, wait for it to maybe go on clearance or watch some other reviews and maybe that'll change your opinion. But other than that, that's all. Those are my two cents. But I look forward to hearing your thoughts in the comment section below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!